Okay, this is unit number 4 of your grade 7 English pupil book. This unit is called A Busy Day. Right, now activity 1 is to act out. Let's see, at the end of this act, you have some questions. It is always a good strategy to read the questions before you read the piece. You have an idea what questions are asked, so you can read with your questions in mind, so it's easier for you to highlight and grab the answers. Okay, take 1 minute and read the questions. When does Lahiru have scout practices? Who has taken Lahiru's logbook? Name the friends who do scouting with Lahiru. Why has Darren not returned Lahiru's book? Why was Lahiru in a hurry to go? What did Lahiru forget to take with him and where was it? Now we know all the 6 questions they are going to ask. Now we are going to read the act, right? I will just read it for you. Please listen. Lahiru woke up at 5 a.m. to go to school. He made his bed, washed his face, and went to kitchen to collect his lunchbox. Now, from here onwards, we have a dialogue going between mother and Lahiru. Here's your lunch. Do you have cricket practices today? Not today, mother. I have scouting this afternoon. You had cricket practices on Fridays last year, but this year you have scouting. Have they changed the practice days? Yes, they have. The coach decided to change the practice days. The teacher in charge will send you a letter with the new days. Is Ilham staying after school with you? Yes, mother, and Krishna too. Oh, that's good. You can share your lunch with your friends. What time will you finish? At 5. Mother, can you ask Darren's mother to bring my scout logbook? He took it home last week and he's not well and I need the logbook today. All right, I'll ask her. Here's your water bottle. Take your cap and the scout uniform. Ah, there comes the bus. Bye, sister. Now sister also comes into the play. Bye, where's your cap? Oh, I forgot it. Can you get it for me, please? It's on my table. Here you are. Bye. Bye. Anyways, Lahiru forgot to say thank you to his mother and sister, right? Okay. Let's get back to the questions. We already read the questions. Now we know the answers, right? When does Lahiru have scouting practices? Very good. On Fridays. If it is something habitual that you go to scouting practices every Friday, you have to say on Fridays. Very good. Who has taken Lahiru's logbook?
Darren.
Darren. Very good. Darren has taken Lahiru's logbook. Name the friends who do scouting with Lahiru. What were the friends' names?
Ilham.
Krishna.
And Darren. Even though Darren is sick, he could not participate. He is a friend that goes scouting with Lahiru. Next one. Why has Darren not returned Lahiru's book?
Because he is not well.
Yes, because he is not well. Why was Lahiru in a hurry to go?
Because his bus was coming.
Because his bus was coming. If he was not quick enough, he would miss the bus. He would miss the bus, right? What did Lahiru forget to take with him and where was it?
His cap.
He forgot his cap?
His table.
Yes, and it was on his table. Very good. Okay. Now we are moving on to activity number 3. Listen closely. Here is a notice. Read and complete the table below. Now see, you can see a notice. The 8th Scout Troop of Dharmapala College proudly presents. Now a troop of scouts means a group of boys who do scouting, right? A Trip to Heaven. It is a drama based on a popular folk tale. Folk tales are the stories of ancient people, our ancestors, right? This is held on 3rd of May 2016 at 2:30 p.m. This is the time, this is the date. And the venue, where is the place? In the school main hall. Right? Now, Dharmapala College has a main hall. Now, the drama will be staged in the main hall of Dharmapala College. Okay. Now tell me the answers. What is the name of the drama? What is the name?
Dharmapala College.
Now Christine, that is a school in Sri Lanka. Now what is the drama's name?
A Trip to Heaven.
Very good. A Trip to Heaven is the name of the drama.
A Trip to Heaven.
Heaven. Heaven means where the gods live, right? Because it is a name, you have to write all the important words in capital. You do not try to, you don't need to use capital letters to write unimportant words like to, for, in, right? So here A capital, T capital, H capital. A Trip to Heaven. Date. On which day will this drama staged?
3rd May 2016.
Yes, this is the day it will be staged on 3rd of May in 2016. At what time?
2:30 p.m.
At 2:30 in the afternoon. Post meridian, that's why it says PM. Now, who is really presenting the drama? It's presented by who?
Scout Troop of Dharmapala College.
Yes, very good. The children who are scouting, the scout troop of Dharmapala College, right? And the venue, that means the place of acting, is?
In the main hall.
Yes, the school main hall. Venue is the school main hall. Okay, children, now we are moving on to activity 4. It is a note. We have some words here as answers, and you need to fill in the blanks here using these words. This is a note written by Tamal to Lahiru. Lahiru, Uncle Sanjay gave me 2 blank to watch the drama A Trip to Heaven. It will be on blank 3rd May at blank in a school blank. Will you come with me? Please blank soon. Tamar. Okay, please do it yourself first. Quickly think where the answers should go. Okay, now I'm going to read it for the second time. Please tell me the answers. Lahiru, Uncle Sanjay gave me 2
passes.
Yes, what do you mean by passes? Tickets. So what did Uncle Sanjay give me? 2
passes.
Passes.
Passes are a paper showing you the permission to go in somewhere, right? Like a ticket. Uncle Sanjay gave me 2 passes to watch the drama A Trip to Heaven. It will be on
Monday,
very good. 3rd May at what time? Monday, 3rd May at 2:30 p.m. In our school?
Main hall.
Now this is where they stop the sentence. So I have to put the full stop as well. Will you come with me? What is the answer here, Chetina? Please.
Reply.
Please reply soon. Very good. Tamar. Now we have to write a reply to Tamar. What shall we say? Yes? Now, if you are writing another letter or note to Tamar, how would you write? We will first do the address. Tamar. Now, someone has just invited you to go to a drama. What is the first thing you should do? Say.
Thank you.
Thank you. You have to say thank you first. Very good. Let's say. Thank you so much for your invitation. Now there are 2 options. One is accepting the invitation. That means say yes, let's go. The other thing is on that day he has some other thing, so he can't come. So in that case you have to apologize and say, I'm really sorry. I'm so sorry to say that I won't be able to come because I have this thing. Right? Now let's say he is accepting here. Thank you so much for your invitation. Right? I'd be very glad to join you joined you to watch this drama. Since it is a note, you have to keep it short and sweet, right? Now we will say, let's meet on, I'll see you on, which day? Monday. I'll see you on Monday. It says it will be on Monday, right? So, Lahiru says, I'll see you on Monday. Sorry, Lahiru says the drama is on. Sorry, it is Tamal. Tamal is writing. Tamal says the drama is on Monday. So Lahiru is saying, I'll see you on Monday. And then post the letter. This could be your reply. If you decline the invitation, that means you do not accept it because you have some other important event, right? Then you say thank you so much. In either case, you have to thank first. Thank you so much for your invitation. I'm very sorry that I won't be able to join you because I have to attend this important event on the same day, right? And then you will say, thank you again for inviting me. Let's try to watch a drama maybe on a later date, right? Like that you will say, right? Now we have a reading activity, right? Now, at the end of this activity, we have some questions. Now, as I always say, before starting your reading, you have to look at your questions so you instantly know the answers. Now, here we have to find out if these statements are true or false. A, Sinbad had a large fortune. Now, when you read, see if he was rich. He had a lot of money, large fortune. The ship stayed in several harbors. A harbor is a place where ships are anchored. Ships are stopped and parked, kind of, right? They landed on an island. The creature was big. Sinbad swam to an island. Now we will find out if these were true or false statements. Next, we have to answer these questions. Where did Sinbad sail? Where did he go sailing? What happened to the ship? Where did Sinbad and his crew land? Write a description of Sinbad. Okay, now we already know this is about Sinbad, right? Now, write an ending to the story. Oh, that's a big job. Now they have definitely stopped before the ending. We have to guess and write an ending to the story. We are free to write a happy ending or a sad ending, right? It is up to us. Now let's go and read. Have you heard of the seven voyages of Sinbad? Here is a part of his first voyage. Read and answer the questions. When I was a young man, my father died, leaving me a very large fortune. Now I'm finding my answers to the questions. I spent most of it enjoying myself. At last, I began to think unless I wish to become poor, I had better try to make some more money. So having bought some goods, I set sail for the Persian Gulf, hoping to sell or exchange them at a profit. The ship stopped at several ports where we did some good trading. One day, when the ship could not move, we saw what seemed to be a little green field peeping above the water. Thinking it very strange, a group of us rowed out to it, taking some fire and food. We had all landed and were in the middle of our meal when we found, to our horror, that we were on the back of some huge sea monster. The creature shook his great body and lashed its tail so angrily that many jumped into the boat, others into the sea, and soon I was the only one on the sea monster. Right. Okay. Now, children, I managed to highlight certain points where we came across that we need to find if these statements are true or false. Right. So we found that Sinbad is a very rich person. Why? His father left him a large fortune, and then what happened? He enjoyed a lot of money and he thought he will become poor, and he decided to earn some more money. Right? What did he do to earn some money? He set sail, right? And he was selling things. So the ship he was sailing stopped at several ports. That means he was stopping at several harbors where he did some good trading. Trading means selling and buying, right? One day, the ship could not move, right? And they saw a little green field, right? A little green field that looked like an island. So they went and they rowed the boat, right? And then finally started having a meal. Then when they were eating halfway, in the middle of their meal, they found out it was not really an island. It was a huge sea monster, right? Then the creature got very angry. He was shaking his big body. Then what happened? Some sailors jumped into the boat and a few others jumped into the sea. And what happened to Sinbad? He was the only one on the sea monster. He did not jump into a boat, or he did not jump into the sea. He neither jumped into the boat nor the sea. Right? Now let's go and answer the questions. You all tell me true or false. Sinbad had a large fortune. True or false? Yes? Sinbad had a large fortune. Did he have a lot of money?
True.
Yes, it's true. He inherited from his father. The ship sailed to several harbors. True or false? Did he stop his ship in several places, ports? so that he can sell goods? Is it true?
Yes, teacher, true. It's
true. They landed on an island. Did they really land on an island?
False.
False. They actually landed on a sea creature, sea monster, not an island. The creature was big.
True.
Correct.
True.
And Sinbad swam to an island. Did he swim anywhere?
False.
No, he was there on the sea monster. False. Very good. Now let's move on to the questions. Where did Sinbad sail? Yes. He set sail for? Where? Where did he set sail? He set sail for the Persian Gulf. He set sail for the Persian Gulf. Next question. Why did he go sailing? Why? What was the reason that he sailed? Why? He wanted to
make some more money.
Yes, he wanted to make some more money. He did not wish to be poor. Right? He knew that his father had left him a large fortune, but he is a clever boy. He thought that money is not going to last forever. So he wanted to make some more money. Right. The next question. What happened to the ship?
Ship could not move.
Yes, one day, very good. One day, the ship could not move. Okay, the next question. Where did Sinbad and his crew land? Where? Where did he land? On a
huge sea monster.
Correct. Very good. They landed on a huge sea monster, which seemed to be a little green field. Now, the next one is a description of Sinbad. We have to write a description of Sinbad. Okay. How can you describe this boy? Now, looking at what happened here so far, we can just guess what sort of a character he is. Yes? What sort of a person is he? I spent most of it enjoying myself. What can you think of a character when you hear this one? Father gave him a lot of money and he spent most of it enjoying himself. Was he a serious character or a playful character? What do you think? Was he a serious character that in his young age, or was he kind of a more playful person who would just go and enjoy himself?
He's more playful character.
Yes, Anna, we will start writing. Sinbad seemed to be a playful character in his younger days, right? And then what happened? Is he a foolish person? Is he a foolish person to spend all of it and become very poor? Yes or no?
No.
No. Then he was a wise person, right? He was clever. He was smart enough to understand the father's money was not going to last forever, right? However, now he seemed to be a playful character. However, he began to think more seriously, right? I will give you time to write later, but just engage in the lesson, okay? Just understand what we are saying here. However, he began to think more seriously about his finances. Finances means his money, right? And he actually started sailing. He set sail. Now those days, did people regard people who went to sea, right, brave or timid? People who set sail in the sea, like the sailors, the captains, were they regarded as brave people or timid people?
Brave people.
Brave people. The ocean is a very dangerous place with so many unknown territories, right? We never know if you are able to come back home or not once you set sail. So Sinbad has to be a brave person. Now since we are writing in past tense, right? He was a brave, let's say, man. He was a brave man and set sail. And what did he do for a business? He bought some goods and then went to the set sail for the Persian Gulf and then sold them at a profit. That means if he bought the goods for 100 rupees, he sold the goods for 150 rupees. Now he has a 50 rupees profit, right? So do you think he is a smart person or a clever, foolish person? Yes, he was making profits. So what sort of a person was he?
Smart person.
Yes, he was smart enough to trade goods for a profit. Okay. Now, until the last one. Now here, when they understood that they were on the back of some huge sea monster, most of them jumped to the boat and others jumped into the sea. But Sinbad was the only one who remained on the sea monster. What does that say about his character? Yes, what does it say about his character? Does he look like a person who runs away from a problem or he wants to stay there and tackle the problem? Yes, I'm giving you answers, you just have to repeat. Does he look like a person who runs away from problems or does he look like a person who can face the problems and tackle them?
He likes to face the problems.
He likes to face challenges and problems. Very good. He remained on the sea monster. Maybe because that is just a guess about this character, okay? Sea monster because seemingly. We use the word seemingly, apparently, for the things that we think to be true, right? Because seemingly, he wanted to fight the sea monster. Okay, now take 2 minutes and quickly write this one. Children, have you finished writing?
Yes, teacher.
No? Okay. Now we have to think of an ending to the story. Can someone please tell me a simple ending to the story? What might have happened? Now there are three kinds of people we need to think about. The people in the boat, the people in the sea, and the one person on the sea monster. What do you think happened? We all know that Sinbad was brave enough to stay there and maybe try to find the sea monster. Maybe at the end, he failed. Maybe at the end, he won. What sort of an ending do you want for this story? One of you, please tell me. What would you want the story to end with?
He won the fight with monster.
That's how you want to end the story. All right, very good. Then how will we write? We will start from where we are stopped, where we have left. Soon I was the only one on the sea monster. Now this story is written in first person. That means if I am Sinbad, I'm writing my life story. Now Sinbad is saying, when I was a young man, my father died, like that. He's telling his life story. Now you have to continue just like that. Because we are writing the end to this story. Okay. Or otherwise you can decide if you are going to write in third person, what happened to Sinbad as your own ending. You can choose any way you like, right? And just tell me how you should write this one. You can say, the sea monster then started swimming very fast, right? And it knocked the boat, and all the sailors in the boat fell into the sea. Then what happened? I could see the boat crashed into pieces, and then sailors hanging on to little pieces of wood and trying to swim. Right? And then? Yes? You all can join as well. This is how the story goes in my mind. If you think the boat didn't crash or the sea monster did not destroy the boat, you can do like that. You can write the story like that. And then finally, Sinbad could maybe find a weapon and then try to kill the sea monster and finally win. Or else, he could have led the sea monster to a real island and then jumped the island and save his life without the sea monster. There are so many options when it comes to a story, because this is fiction. Fiction means imagined stories. You can imagine anything you want. That is the beauty of stories, right? You can end a story in any way you like. Right. Now I will leave you to it. You can write the answer as you wish. Now we are moving on to activity 6. Form groups and narrate a similar folk story from Sri Lanka or from another country to the class. Now we just heard a story, right? A story of Sinbad. I don't think this is a Sri Lankan one, right? Is there anyone who would like to share a Sri Lankan story? Now, in this class, we have foreign students as well, right? Christine, you want to share any folk tale from your country? How about the Sri Lankan students? We have so many folk stories, right? All right, now we have a little less time now. We will form groups and, you know, tell stories when we get together, right? Okay. Let's move on to the next one. Collective nouns. Study these phrases. A litter of puppies, a herd of cows, a bunch of flowers, a flock of pigeons, a bunch of ripe bananas. The words in bold are called collective nouns. We use collective nouns to bring a group of people or objects together. Now, if you have so many puppies together, you call them a litter of puppies. Now, it will be very boring for us to use the same word group. A group of puppies, a group of bananas, a group of whales, a group of singers, a group of musicians, right? It will be very boring. So these particular nouns have different collective forms, collective names to identify the groups, right? I will show you some more. Before we go to activity 7, I will show you some collective nouns. If you have a group of ants, you call that an army of ants. This is the word used to talk about a lot of ants in a group, right? Now I will be just showing you slides and reading. What you need to understand is, if you see these groups, these words are the ones which you need to identify the groups. Now here, if you have seen a lot of ants, you call them an army of ants. Okay, let's keep on. An army of soldiers, a band of musicians, a bench of bishops, a bench of magistrates, a board of directors, a brood of chickens, a building of rooks, a choir of singers, a class of pupils, that's what we are here, a class of students, a herd of cattle, a host of angels, a litter of cubs, a litter of pups or puppies, a nest of rabbits, a pack of rascals. Rascals means naughty children, right? Who are always up to mischief. A pack of wolves, a plague of insects, a plague of locusts. You can see a locust here. When you go in a desert, usually we have plagues of locusts, and people who are lost in the desert usually eat them. A pride of lions, a school of whales, a company of actors. This is a stage drama, and all these people you can see are actors. A covey of grouse, a crew of sailors, a drove of cattle. Here the word drove does not mean the past tense of drive. This is a collective name for cattle. Cattle includes cows, bulls and calves, right? A flock of birds, a flock of sheep, a gaggle of geese, a gang of laborers, a gang of thieves, a group of friends, a herd of buffaloes, a shoal of herring. Herring is a little fish, right? We eat that fish. Now, one herring, now herring is a singular noun. Even if you have a million herring, you do not say herrings. Like sheep, one sheep, 100 sheep. One salmon, 100 salmon. One cod, 100 cod. One herring, 100 herring. These nouns do not have a plural form, right? Even if you have a lot, you do not add s. One deer, 100 deer, like that. A staff of servants, a staff of teachers, a stud of horses, a swarm of bees, a swarm of insects. Now children, what you can see is a desert area, right? A team of horses, a team of oxen, a team of players, a troop of monkeys, a troop of dancers. These dancers are dancing ballet. A bale of cotton, a bale of wool, a batch of bread, a bouquet of flowers, a bunch of grapes, a bundle of rags. Now, I just remembered we call a bunch of bananas as well. I did not put a picture of that. Okay, remember that. A bunch of keys, a bunch of bananas, a bunch of grapes, right? You can say a bunch of flowers as well, right? A bundle of rags. Rags means old clothes that you do not use for clothing purposes. A chest of drawers. A clump of trees, when you have a lot of trees together. A cluster of diamonds. A cluster of stars. A clutch of eggs. A collection of pictures. A crate of fruit. Fruit is also an uncountable noun. Right, when you say fruit, you do not add s, right? There are bananas, apples, oranges, and so many varieties of fruit. A fleet of cars, a fleet of ships. Now here the picture is not correct. Actually, a flight of aeroplanes should have so many aeroplanes flying together, right? Flight of aeroplanes. This is only one aeroplane, which is not correct. I will change the picture later, okay? A flight of steps, a forest of trees, a hail of fire, a hedge of bushes, a library of books, a pack of cards, some people say a deck of cards as well, a rope of pearls, a set of china. Here china, see, simple. You have to remember this is not the country china. You call this kind of plates, dishes, and the teacups, sugar containers, all these things together, you call it a set of china, right? A porcelain set of plates. A set of clubs. These are used in playing golf. A set of tools. A sheaf of corn. A stack of hay. Hay means dried stalks of grain, sometimes paddy as well. A string of beads. So many of you have fun bracelets like this, right? A suit of clothes. Your fathers have suits like this, which they wear for formal occasions. He has suite of furniture. This word is suit, whereas this word is suite. A suite of furniture. Furniture is also an uncountable noun, a singular noun. You do not say furnitures, right? It is singular. It is a singular noun, just like equipment, right? Deer, sheep, furniture. A suite of rooms. A tuft of grass. Right. I'm not going to go ahead with this one. Now this is enough. We will go back to our lesson. You learned so many collective nouns, right? If you do not remember, please see the video once again. Now activity 7 asks us to fill in this puzzle, right? There's a crossword puzzle. You have to read this and first fill in the blanks and then we will go to the puzzle. Okay, let's do this one now. Let's fill in the blanks first. Across. What's number one? Who can read the whole sentence? Senuja?
Do you want another scoop of ice cream?
Very good. Okay. Who can read the next one?
My little sister is eating a bar of chocolate.
Bar of chocolate. Bar of chocolate. Next one. In the night sky, I saw a
galaxy of stars.
Galaxy of stars. In the presentation, we learned another word, a cluster of stars. Okay. My mother bought a
tube of toothpaste.
Yes, tube of toothpaste. Very good. Add a
clove of garlic to the dal curry.
Garlic. Very good. I will show you a clove of garlic. Now this is the garlic bulb. In the bulb you have so many cloves. When you want to plant garlic, you plant the cloves separately, right? So these are cloves. A clove of garlic. Correct. Next one. A pack of wolves landing in the jungle. Very good. Next one. Down.
A swarm of bees
attacked the tourists at Seagilia. Next one. A fleet of ships. Arrived at the Colombo Harbor. Very good. There isn't a what of dust.
A speck of dust
in my sister's room. Give me a
drop of water, please.
So it's drop, not cup. You can always say a bottle of water, glass of water, a cup of water, like that. But here it's drop. Okay, let's start filling these blanks, children. Excuse me. Okay, this is how your puzzle looks like after filling. Usually we fill puzzles with capital letters, but this one had simple letters, so we went ahead with simple letters. Okay, now children, we are moving on to activity 8. Let's make a kaleidoscope. Oh, now at your school, have you made this one under a science project? Kaleidoscope? Yes, now this is a kaleidoscope. You know, you get 3 rectangular pieces of mirror and then you tape them together, then put inside a tube, or you just maybe you just wrap some tape over it, and then when you put some objects in that, you can see beautiful designs. Kaleidoscope. I will show you some designs you can see through a kaleidoscope. They are wonderful, beautiful, right? Even when we were small, we made this one at school. I still remember mine. Okay? There were so many beautiful designs. We could see even if you put the ugliest things, it makes a lot of beautiful patterns like this. Kaleidoscope. Okay. What do you need? 3 rectangular shaped mirrors of medium length, a cello tape, a PVC tube of same length, a lid or an end cap, a lid or an end cap to close the PVC tube. Here are the steps. Complete the blanks using the following words. Now, children, these 5 words are the answers, right? Fix, place, wind. Sorry, this one has to be wind. Put and insert. Now, these are verbs. Now, take a minute, please, and try to do this yourselves. Okay. First, what should come here? First, blank the mirrors carefully into a triangle, shiny sides in. What should be done here? First, you have to yes. What do? You have to keep them in place. So, what is the verb here? First,
place.
Yes, first place the mirrors carefully into a triangle. Shiny sides in. Very good. Then what do? Then?
Wind.
Yes. Okay, what should you do with the tape? You should?
Wind.
Yes, you should wind the tape around the triangle. Half inch from each end. Then what do?
Then next insert the mirrors into the PVC tube.
Yes, you have to insert the mirrors into the PVC tube. Then what should you do?
Then fix
the PVC and cap.
Yes.
Onto the PVC tube.
Yes, very good. Then finally,
put small beads, buttons, or colorful paper balls and enjoy the view.
Very good. Okay, now we have come to a grammar lesson here called possessive pronouns. Now possessive, the word possessive means children. What belongs to whom? Possessive means a word showing ownership. If you look at your book, that book is yours. If I look at this laptop is mine. So which object has ownership of a person, right? Now a person has, if a person has ownership of an object, you use possessive pronouns or possessive nouns to express that belongingness, express that ownership, right? Study this. Here's your cap. The cap is yours. He took my book last week. This book is mine. You forgot to take your cap. It's yours. He went to see his paddy field. The paddy field was his. We use possessive pronouns to refer to ownership. Possessive pronouns replace nouns in sentences. Now here, they have used pronouns instead of nouns. Now here, you could have said John or the boy, but instead they used he. So what are the pronouns? He, she, it, we, you, they, I. Those are the pronouns, right? Subject pronoun is I. When you want to describe your ownership, you say my. It's an adjective. Whose book? My book. Now you are describing the book. So possessive pronoun. Whose book is this? It is mine. Okay. All of you please join to read this with me. I, my, mine. Please read.
I, my, mine.
We are ours.
We are
us.
You, yours.
You, yours. He, his. She, hers.
She, hers.
It's.
It's.
They, theirs.
They, theirs.
Right, now let me tell you sentences. Now subject means the person who's doing something. I am reading my book. This book is mine. Now listen to these sentences very carefully. We are reading. Who are reading? We are reading. That is the subject, the people or person who are doing something. We are reading our books. Whose books? Our books. These books are ours. You are reading your book. And this book is yours. He is reading his book. This book is his. She is reading her book. And this book is hers. It is drinking milk. This milk is its milk. Its milk. This is its milk. and this milk is its. Now when you write its, why didn't we use an apostrophe like this? What is the meaning of it apostrophe s its? This is the shortened form of it.
Yes.
Yes. If you write with an apostrophe, this means it is. But when you write it's without an apostrophe, it means something that belongs to an animal or an object. Now imagine this is a cat. Okay? This is its tail. And this tail is its. Okay. They are reading. They are reading their books. These books are theirs. Okay. Now let's go to activity 9. Fill in the blanks with the correct possessive pronoun. This pen belongs to me. It's mine. Now you tell me the answers. This pair of spectacles belongs to my father. It's father means this one. It is his. Full stop. This small book belongs to Murali, a boy. It's
his.
That small piece of land belongs to Mr. and Mrs. Gamage. There are two people who have the ownership of this land. So it is?
Yes.
Theirs. There are two people. Plural pronoun. Theirs. The biggest room in the house belongs to me and my brother.
Us.
Us. Full stop. That floral dress belongs to my mother.
Hers.
The white prayer hat belongs to Nizam.
His.
Full stop. Very good. There's some more. There are some more. The new hat belongs to you.
Yours.
Yours. These pencil boxes belong to my friends. They are?
Not me.
It doesn't belong to me, children.
Theirs.
Yes, these pencil boxes belong to my friends. They are theirs. Next one. The shop belongs to them. It's? Yes?
Theirs.
It's theirs. Very good. Well done. Now you have to underline the best answer. I'd rather write it here. Okay? This book is? What is the correct answer? This book is?
Mine.
This book is mine, but you can have it. Next one, please return.
My pencil.
Now I will tell you a trick, children. This one, remember, when you have an adjective, now these ones are, this column is called possessive adjectives, right? So what do you mean by an adjective? An adjective always describes a what? What does it describe? What did I write?
Noun.
Yes, it describes a noun. An adjective always describes a noun. So, if you have a noun after these adjectives, right, that means these are possessive adjectives. For example, my pencil. Our erasers, your bag. Do you understand, children? If you have a noun here, that means what should come to this column? A possessive adjective. Now here, it says pencil. Here, this book is blank. The next word is but. Is but a noun?
No.
No. Then my should not be the answer. There has to be a noun after my. My what? My bag. My what? My pencil. My what? My brother. It has to be a place, a person, or an animal, or a thing. Then only it will become a possessive adjective. Now here, it is pencil. This is a noun. So it definitely has to be a possessive adjective. My pencil. You don't say mine pencil, right? It's my pencil. Okay. Now let's go to number three. Blank handwriting is very neat. Now we can see a noun here. Handwriting, something. So which one is the answer? Quickly go and see what is in this column. What is in this column? If you have a noun after that, always the previous one should be a possessive adjective. What is the answer? Yes? Yeah. Your handwriting. Next one. This is blank school tie. Again a noun. Now you should see something that is in the possessive adjective column. What is it? This is?
His.
His school tie. Very good. Punsara found his file, but Purni couldn't find. Now there's no noun after that. So that means it should be a possessive pronoun. Hers. Very good. Yes. No noun after that. Full stop. They have already put the full stop. No need. Okay. I like their story, but they prefer. No noun after that.
Mine.
Very good. Your class is neat, but again, this is not a noun. Ours is untidy. Very good. Now children, if they had class after this, your class is neat, but blank class is untidy. Now there's a noun. Then you say our class, right? But here no noun. So you do not put a possessive adjective there. Next one. I like your essay. Do you like?
Mine.
Mine.
Do you like mine? Okay. All the drawings were good, but blank, no noun, the best. What's the best? Me? He is the subject, children. He is the subject. Now this one is in the object side. Whose one? Whose one was the best? His one. Now you can see this one is also his. This one is also his. There's no change. Now in this case, no noun, so still it will be his. This is his drawing. The best was his. Our broom is lost. Can we use?
Yours.
Yours.
Yes.
Very good. Well done. If we had broom at the end, our broom is lost. Can we use your broom? Now then that's fine. Right. Next one. Complete these sentences with the correct form of the word in brackets. This class is whose class? This class yours. Is yours. Keep it clean. No noun after that. This writing book is
mine.
Mine. Now here you can see, children, if you take a quick look, there are no nouns after that. We have to write the last word. That means all your answers are coming from this column. All your answers. Okay. That house is?
Us.
Us.
Very good. The ring is?
Hers.
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 Very good. Now you're answering like fireworks. Very good. We met Paul and Jane last night. This house is?
Theirs.
Theirs.
The luggage is?
His.
His.
His actually doesn't change. The pictures are?
Hers.
Hers.
The cat is?
Us.
Us.
Well done. This class is very good. Now, we are moving on to activity 10, which is a listening test. This is the timetable of grade 7B. The principal has made some changes in it. Listen to your teacher and make the changes. Now take a good look at the timetable. Okay. I'm just going to improvise some changes and you should tell me. And then after I read, you need to show on my screen which ones to change. I'm going to start reading. Please listen carefully. Dear children, I have an announcement for you. The principal has made some changes to our timetables. Instead of having aesthetics on Monday on the second period, we will be having science. Please make changes, okay? Science. Let me repeat. Instead of having aesthetics on the second period of Monday, we will be having science. And the fifth period of Tuesday is going to be history instead of Tamil. On Friday after the interval, we will not be having two periods for aesthetics. We will have the fifth period for aesthetics, but the sixth period will be mathematics. So you will have two periods of mathematics after interval on Friday. There is one final change, children. The library will be closed on Wednesdays. So we will not be able to have the library period on Wednesday. Instead of that, we will be having an English period there. And the library will be open on Thursday, so we will replace the English period with the library period. So we are basically switching library period on Wednesday to Thursday, and Thursday's English period will be switched to Wednesday's library period. Thank you. Now that is the announcement. Now let's replay the announcement and check the answer. Let's read.
Having aesthetics on the second period of Monday.
Now, children, are you ready with the changes? Did you do your changes in the book?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, now I will do the changes here on the timetable. Please check if your answers are correct.
On the second period of Monday, we will be having science. And the fifth period of Tuesday is history in Tamil. Friday after the interval, we will not be having two periods for aesthetics. We will have the fifth period for aesthetics, but the sixth period will be mathematics. So you will have two periods of mathematics after interval on Friday. One final change, children. The library will be closed on Wednesdays. So we will not be able to have the library period on Wednesday. Instead of that, we will be having an English period there. And the library will be open on Thursday, so we will replace the English period with the library period. So we are basically switching library period on Wednesday to Thursday, and Thursday's English period will be switched to Wednesday's library period.
Very good. Did you get all the answers correct? Yes or no? Did you get all the answers correct? Oh, was there anything wrong that you need some clarification on? Yes, did you get all correct?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Now we have finished unit 4. Thank you for participating in the class today. Well done. You are doing very good. So we will be attempting the workbook next week. I want you to do this at home alone, and then we will be discussing the answers next week. Okay.